wherever you envision yourself working in the future, whether it's academics or private practice, we can work with you to achieve that goal.
The fellows just get to operate and have some time in clinic, but it's mainly an operative fellowship.
The OR staff are very supportive. The environment is a wonderful learning experience.
We have a great relationship with the faculty and the fellows, great working relationship, and we're really driven for their success. We offer a one-year and a two-year fellowship. The two-year fellowship would include either basic science research in a lab, an MPH, Master of Public Health, Master's of Science, or an MBA. Your first year, we typically have between 40 to 50% research, and then the other half would be clinical. And then your second year, most of your schooling and research is complete, or you're completing those projects, and would be more clinically geared. So around 70 to 80% of your time would then be clinical, with around 20 to 30% of your time research-based. All of our fellows, to our two-year fellows, will apply for the AUA Scholars grant. We will work with you to create a prospective grant application and submit that. We don't require that you get funded for that grant, but at least that you are submitting for the AUA Scholars grant. During their first year of fellowship, our fellows every 6 weeks will take a weekend call as primary call, and then the staff, either Dr. Large or myself, will be taking a secondary call with them at that time. The second year fellow will perform staff call. And so they'll cover the IU North Hospital, Methodist Hospital, and IU West Hospital. And they will also get phone calls from outside ERs for admissions and transfers. The fellow responsibility with the residents would include organizing our LithLink conferences, or our STONED metabolic evaluation conferences, where we go through typical 24-hour urine studies, go through stone pathogenesis, and assist with teaching the residents on how to evaluate patients with stone disease and how to prevent stone events in those patients that we operate on. The fellowship is geared around two central clinical faculty, that's Dr. Large and myself, and then we have our adjunct faculty, which would include Dr. Ronald Boris, Dr. Matt Mellon. They are faculty we work with at Methodist. Dr. Mellon is our division chief here at Methodist, so the fellows will work with them on call and sometimes do emergency cases with them. We also have research faculty, Dr. James Williams. He's our PhD and runs a basic science lab. He's a world expert in stone disease pathogenesis. We're involved with several projects with him, as well as Tarek Ashkar with the Department of Nephrology. He's also a basic scientist who we're working with on a kidney precision medicine project.
I did my residency at IU, and then I did my fellowship here, and then stayed on. The fellowship here met the biggest requirement for me, which was the same for residency, and that is that I wanted the best surgical training. And I really believe, having worked with different people, that both residency and fellowship afford trainees that really there's no other surgery, hands-on, one-on-one mentorship anywhere else in the country.
I chose to come to IU Methodist for fellowship because of the depth of the surgical training as far as endourology goes, in terms of the diversity of the patient population, pathologies that are seen here, and the ability to learn from surgeons who all have a slightly different take on how they do things and how things are managed. Indianapolis is also a fun place to live.
Living in the city, I think, but for me was quite enjoyable, because it gives you a unique situation where you can be in and out of the hospital very fast. And when you're a fellow, you often have kids or family, and so coming and going is a lot easier than some slightly more desirable cities that have fellowships, where you might spend half your day commuting.
We are the only academic medical center in Indiana, so we receive complex kidney stone referrals from all over the state and the tri-state area. The procedures that we typically specialize in our fellowship are complex PCNL. That would include both miniature PCNL and the really big, massive patients with Staghorn calculi that require multiple procedures to remove their stone disease. We also specialize in holmium laser enucleation of the prostate, or HOLEP. That was pioneered here by Dr. Lingeman about 25 years ago. We are likely the largest volume center in the United States for that.
The surgical experience, I don't think there's a match in the nation as far as training numbers and then the people training.
Most of our fellows do pursue academic careers, and so we have fellows who are academic endourologists throughout the United States. We also have fellows who are in Canada who are academic endourologists there. But we also have previous fellows who have graduated who are in private practice and kind of the stone person or the BPH person for that practice.
When I was going through, the social events were very numerous. We always traveled as a unit when we went to the conferences. And that felt very encapsulating and very reassuring, because sometimes those are your first time presenting big projects and talking to very reputable individuals in the community.
My favorite thing about the fellowship is the camaraderie with the staff in clinic and the operating room staff. We always have a good time, even if it's a tough case or a tough day.
The biggest strength of our program is that we have kind of the trifecta here. We have extremely complex stone disease patients. We have a great referral practice for our HOLA patients. We are on the cutting edge in terms of technology. We, you know, are dismissing patients same day and dismissing them and removing their catheter same day post-HOLA. We're doing the similar things for percutaneous stone removal. In terms of our research curriculum, we have funding, you know, with the NIH and the NIDDK. We also have research databases that we can use to get preliminary data for grants, and then also write research projects. And we, you know, have, you know, high expectations in terms of publications and doing prospective studies as well. And then lastly, I think the mentorship is a big thing for me and Tim as well, to make sure that we have you know, a great relationship with our fellows. And that we, you know, really have this relationship going forward. This is really kind of a lifelong relationship that you'll have with us if you do decide to join our team.
The new fellows for sure are getting exposed to a completely different environment than what I went through as a fellow. And it seems to me like as the years are gonna go by, this is gonna become kind of an epicenter for the care of complex stones and BPH. It's just no match for what we are going to be able to achieve in both clinical care, delivery of care, systems update, narcotic-free approaches, and then stone, like basic science research and prevention. I wouldn't be surprised if some unbelievable research comes out of this institution just because of the sheer manpower that is applying to a single very specialized thing, which is very rare to find.